In this tutorial, we'll learn how to model a very simple Gothic vault. Before you start modeling objects, study it. Find references. Drawings are the best because you can clearly see all the parts. As you can see, Gothic arch has sharp points. So you can start modeling arch from spline. Use ellipse as the base. Next, convert ellipse to spline. Right click, convert to editable spline. Click on segments and select two bottom segments and delete them. After that, click on verticals and select top vertical and scale it. This will create sharp pointed arch. Go to the modifier list and apply extrude modifier. Change amount to desired length. Go to hierarchy panel and center pivot to the object. Next, center object to the grid. X0, Y0, Z0. Turn on angle snap toggle and in top view hold shift down and rotate 90 degrees to create copy. Next, apply Probillion compound object. Select object, create panel, under standard primitives, pull down menu, choose compound objects and click Probillion. Under Probillion options, select move and union. And then turn on start picking button and select second shape. Turn off start picking options. Right click and convert Probillions to editable poly. Then go to edge selection and select bottom edges. Hold shift down and drag edges down to extrude them. Next, we will create diagonal ribs. Rotate object so you can see inside creases. Set up snap option to vertex, under shape select line and turn on snapping option. Draw a line along inside corner. Right click on the end to finish your line. Turn off snapping options. Go to modifier list and apply swipe modifier. Change angle to cylinder and interpolation to zero steps. Adjust radius to desired size. Go back to hierarchy panel, click affect pivot point only button and center pivot to grid X0, Y0, Z0. Go to tools and choose array. Click rotation button and set Z axis to 360 degrees. Then change count to 4. Click preview to check result and click OK. Next, select Gothic vault, right click and convert to editable poly. Select transverse rib, edge of one of the arches, hold down shift and drag to extrude. Switch to polygonal selection and detach newly created extrusion. Select new mesh and apply shell modifier. Adjust inner and outer amount to desired thickness. Move it to chosen position, reset pivot point. Go to hierarchy panel, click affect pivot point only button and center pivot to grid X0, Y0, Z0. Apply array again. Keep the same settings. Next, create column. Use line and lathe modifier. Draw profile of the column first. Make adjustments as needed. And then go to modifier pull down menu and choose lathe modifier. Place column in one of four corners and reset pivot point again. Apply array one more time. At the end, create boss. Type of decoration that will cover connection between four diagonal ribs. As before, use line and lathe modifier. You may add more decoration if you desire. Thank you and good luck.